Violins.
Violins.
You know, I saw these two kids fighting on the road today.
Oh.
I just grabbed them by the shirt and said, hey.
Hey.
Stop the violins before I come over there.
Yeah, I come over there.
There's little kids.
Don't talk back to me. Mm-hmm. Don't you know your story?
Know your role?
Learn your homework.
Yeah.
Use your eyes, ears, mouth, and nose.
Eat your Weet-Bix.
Beautiful Avondale Markets.
It's a beautiful day today,
and you're watching Fresh.
Welcome to the conversation.
Look at this guy, wow. I think that he really loves that grass by the looks of it.
Okay, here's a present for you.
Yeah, we dedicate this one.
Well, first up, we getting down, we're browning around.
You guys heard of Sugar Pop?
Nah. Who's Sugar Pop? Yeah, who?
Check this out.
Good?
Brakes in a bus, brakes on a car. Brakes to make you a superstar. Brakes to win and brakes to lose. But these here brakes rock your shoes.
How you doing? My name is Sugar Pop, the Electric Boogaloos and the Rocksteady crew who created this dance called Lock It. This dance is spread all over the world, so I'm here to talk about what I do and be running these workshops here in Auckland.
For me, who's a beginner hip-hop dancer, it was a big thing for me because not only because he's Pacific Island, but it's really important to learn from one of the best and one of the original dancers who know their thing.
Definitely an inspiration because I'm from the New Zealand crump community. And to see a legend, a pioneer in that realm, kind of inspires me to do the same.
The origins of this dance all go back to one man, Don Campbell.
And Don really started this whole thing. I bought it for Don Campbell, the Camelot.
I learned how to do this dance in West California. All the other kids, you know, I mean, everybody was just into it at the same time, and everybody got moved by it. The music is always what made these dances. We didn't just go from one style to the other. The music went through this, what I call the funky era. Not the funk era, but the funky era, the James Brown era of music. And a lot of dance, different dances resulted from his music and from the sound that he was putting out. Not just him, but Sly Stone and many others in the late 60s, early 70s. The music always makes a dance. The battle part of it's always been part of it, but not the focus of it, you know. People are dancing now just for what they can get out of it as far as winning a contest or fame or something, instead of just enjoying the music. It's always been about the music. The music moves you and moves you to dance a certain way. I worked with Michael Jackson on Beat It and Thriller and a bunch of other videos. From Inglewood to my city of Carson. You know, I work with Booyah and a couple of the local LA groups. Cypress Hill. Fight the power. Public Enemy, Brand Nubian, Tribe Called Quest. I'm here to just teach about it and to show where it's going and where it's been and where it comes from, but also what can happen with it, what the future of it can be.
Whenever I wanted to. Oh, I can build a castle from a single grain.
Is the
man. Done a few of his workshops before, and they're really funky.
I study dance as well, so hopefully pass on knowledge that Sugar Pop has taught me. And so hopefully spread that out to all of the hip hoppers here in Auckland, New Zealand.
I've heard people say this since I was a kid. Whatever you want to do, you could do it. I've never had a job my whole life, people. I'm 50 years old. I never worked a day in my life. I've done what I want. Just have fun. Do the thing that I've loved since I was a kid, since before I started making kids. I've done this dance. I still love it like the first day that I saw it. And you can really do what you want to do.
Stay tuned, you freshies, because after the break,
you're coming to our world. Undercover stars.
Mow them! Mow them!
Dad, can we go to the shop?
What for? Huh? Go and mow them lawns.
I already did it.
And after that, go and mow your hair. And you know what? Mow your Movember.
Mow your eyebrow.
Mow your ivory.
Welcome back to Fresh.
We're Home Brew.
And this is our world.
Welcome to the conversation.
Oh, I'm Neptunian. Long line of sea gods. Nah, I'm just Balangi. I'm Jewish, whatever, it's all the same.
I'm Nguyen, Hapsong.
I'm full Nguyen. But apparently those don't exist anymore for some reason.
You're the last one?
Lies.
Nah, but you do hang out with, like, the majority of your friends are either islanders.
I just, growing up, I was the only white kid on the street, so to me it always felt like everyone was just the same anyway. Like, you know, whatever ethnicity you were, because you all live on the same street, you all live in the same place. It's kind of, you're from the same village in a way, you know? I never really knew I was different until people started calling me Balangi, you know, or Honky or whatever, you know? Then you realize you're different.
It's pretty intimidating working with these two, just because I like their music. I'm a fan first. Even though I grew up with Tom, it's still hard for me.
Yeah. We all inspire each other. We all like sharpen each other's swords, pause. Riding on a tidal wave, sitting around soaking on the gamma rays, chilling out, hiding from the hurricanes from underneath the shade.
I like it when we like make something, then I'm just like, stank, delete, and you're like, yeah, good call.
Like, you can't have an ego when it comes to the creation, I think, because you got to be willing for other people to say, no, I'm not feeling that part, and if you get all like gentle about it, then it's not gonna work.
There's no one there telling us you have to put an album out, you have to do it like this. Like, we changed all of that, like doing it ourselves.
When we played at the Music Awards, they asked us to do the song about the benefit. You know, then we chucked in a song about John Key because that's what we wanted to see. They asked us to act like buffoons. That's the only way they can figure out to market us, you know? They didn't want to listen to a song that I wrote about East Asia, about the third world, about politics. They didn't want to listen to that. Even if you had the most perfect media portrayal of you, they still wouldn't really know you. No one really knows you. Your own mom doesn't really know you. You just gotta like hope that people like your music, I guess. Like, I would hope that your music explains who you are anyway. I'm an alcoholic. Yeah, that song's about being an alcoholic, you know? But like, if you listen
to
the
whole
album,
no way.
Yeah.
I don't like how people just label us as alcoholics and stuff like that. Like, I do have other things to do than besides drinking.
I remember one time I was in the mall with my mum doing food shopping. Some dude, he was drunk as, it was 12 o'clock.
Oh yeah.
He's like, yeah, Louie, you drunk too? Like,
Nah, I'm with my mum and doing shopping.
I think the buzzy thing you gotta remember when you're young, when you're a teenager, of course you start rebelling. Because your whole life you've been going this way, you want to know what's over the fence, right?
Yeah.
So you start experimenting. And I think the thing you got to remember, when you experiment with drugs and alcohol, you got to remember it's an experiment. Experiments have conclusions. You know, you got to, at some stage, sit there and think, what did I learn from this experiment? And for me, it took too long experimenting. I was like, this is not as good as, like, relying on myself, you know? Relying on my actual energy. I had to go look in a bottle for it. And then you make a conclusion about the experiment.
It does help me perform, like, though.
Wow.
No, but real, it does help you perform, but really, where's that coming from? Hey, that's you up on that stage, my bro. That's you carving it up.
Doesn't mean I need to drink heaps, but I do need at least one or two.
It gets hot on the stage, yeah.
She's hanged on me.
I'd like to be, like, credited for my production. And, like, just music in general.
Damn, being up there with you and the band,
and you just transform me.
The day it's not fun is the day I'll be like, oh, no point. But I don't see that happening.
I'm not too concerned about being remembered. I think, like, you live and then you die, and I don't really care about being remembered. I just want to be loved while I'm here, like, that's about it.
That was great.
I'm not trying to be dark on anything, but...
That's a tweet.
That's a tweet.
Ni hao.
Could I have 10 pork buns, please?
Three.
Shishini.
Thank
you.
Hi, I'm
Pani.
I'm Clive.
And I'm Pugs Pani. And this is Pani and Pani.
And Aunty Tala.
Oh, you're amazing.
You're amazing. That's amazing.
Aunty Tala.
Oh, thanks, guys. Great to be back with you guys.
Yeah. She's amazing.
Oh, I'm incredible.
Yeah, you are.
Dear Bonds and Barnes.
And Aunty Tala.
Oh, and Aunty Taylor. Why am I still single? I'm the prettiest one in the family. That's from single to mingle at bingo. I think this is a really good one for Aunty Taylor because, you know, she's worked lots on marriage counselling and divorce counselling. She needs help.
And she needs to know, even when she reads out things, that, you know, her friends are there for her.
Absolutely. Yeah. We've got your back and your stomach. Yeah. We've got everything.
If you were to write poetry, you know, for and sort of advice form.
Okay. It is. You got a pen and paper?
No.
Well, that's not good. Yes. As I sit on ponder on things gone past, visions of your loveliness come to me as clear as glass. The sun reflecting against your ebbing flowing hair.
Ebbing flowing.
When I see your face in the mirror, it makes me scare.
Oh. Yeah,
that's what her problem is. If she is the prettiest and she's still single, I wonder what the rest of the family look like.
Yeah.
You know?
That poetry was beautiful. That was beautiful.
Yeah, it is. Beyond trees of the hills, the wind will blow. But the river runs dry when the rains must go.
Something else must go.
People walk left, right. But don't dive under, because...
Auntie, speaking of poetry and flow, let's flow to Mr. Fresh.
Let's do it. And
he can I like that.
Flow.
What do we do there?
Thank you.
You know what you remind me of?
Yeah.
Alicia Keys?
Oh.
Yeah, her friend.
Oh, Alicia Keys' friend.
Yeah, her name was Junkie. Lulu. Mr. Lova, Lova, Lova.
Oh, look at this guy. Wow. I think that he really loves that grass by the looks of it.
I'm Hans Masoy. I am a third year actor here at Unitech. Screen and performing arts, and I've sort of been training to be an actor for the last 3.5 years.
Now he's climbing the grass. Who climbs the grass? Even Spider-Man doesn't climb the grass.
I like to stay fit because it's really important to keep the energy up, and I think eating the right food, training every now and then, keeping yourself active. It's a good way to keep your energy up. And you need that when you're rehearsing long hours and you're studying at the same time. I think my mom's a warrior because she's really strong, a strong woman, hardworking, loving and supporting, but at the same time, she'll drop me today, you know, if I step out of line. So she's the warrior in my family anyway.
Oh, that explains it.
So, you know, if you want to get fit,
yeah,
and if we want to get fit, which we don't need to because we're already amazing,
yeah,
we need to go onto like our Facebook page,
yes. Yes.
And then, you know, we can just write up about who's amazing and get some advice, wow, tips from them, yeah, about fitness.
And everyone else there who likes to climb the grass and jump on chairs when you should be sitting down, send in your video and tell us why you're doing those stupid things.
Grass,
keep off the grass.
Keep off.
Yeah, that's
keep
why
off the
you
grass.
Get red eyes.
Wait, you know that sign that says keep off the grass?
Yeah.
How the hell did it get there?
You know why I don't like when they put the sign up, keep off the grass? Because I took my dog, my German Shepherd, for a walk on the grass.
Yeah.
And the man said, can you read the sign? I said, I can. I have my dog can. Because he's a German Shepherd. If they write it in a German, maybe. But I could, if I had a British Bulldog, maybe because it's from Britain, you know.
Riverside Park, Avondale.
Man, funny. Hello. There's some more funny stuff after the break, too.
Tiger and Raa, keep it fresh.
Keep it fresh.
Still in the floor from where my thoughts walk. Memories still in my thoughts. I'm back and forth. Form and talk still drawn upon the wall.
Pizza!
Pizza!
And I will always...
Shh!
Ole pizza!
Wow.
Hey, you want a pizza me?
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 There's a tree in the backyard where my wife always roams. There's a black hole in my backyard where I like to go under the face of the moon.
Welcome back to Fresh. Next on the program is Tiger and Raa.
Yeah, I used to want to be a taxi driver.
Oh, what happened? So
high. Can't drive.
I'm a taxi in the daytime. I'm a hero in the nighttime. And I'm punching all the bad boys. Cause you can run very fast because I know where you are. It's the Avenger of Tiger and
Raa. Oh, Uncle, look at these two fellows, man.
What a stupid idiot.
But they've gone and parked on a disabled parking, bro.
Yep, it is. Better be going and give it a talk.
No, for reals, bro.
Yo, you're lying, bro.
It was like super glassy.
Really?
Pipelines,
for reals?
I was just like turdly in the zone, man.
Who's this guy? Hey, man, what's up?
What's up, bro? What do you think you're doing?
Oh, we're just picking up some food, bro, before we hit some surf.
Oh, is it? Let me tell you something. You know you're parking in a disability.
Disabled.
Oh,
bro.
Sorry, bro.
We're like, disabled. Just gonna be 5 minutes, man. Just gonna get some stuff.
Yeah, man. We're out of here.
What are you laughing for, bro?
Whoa, check out the kid, man.
Better be move your car, bro.
Oh, really, dude? Why don't you and Oompa Loompa just like mind your own business?
Totally, fancy. Okay, all right. I'll be back.
Yeah, no problem, Terminator.
Oh, snappers. Okay, no more chugging. Move the car. Hurry up.
Look, check it out. Like Ren and Stimpy.
Hey, bro. Do you want to park here, like, legally without breaking the law?
Oh, no thanks, officer.
Okay, here's a present for you.
Uh-oh. Told you my uncle legalized the situation.
Yeah, it is. I'm just doing this for help you, you know. This a present for you. It's a disability card because now you are disabled.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, cool.
Okay. Thanks, man. Thanks, dude.
Now you can tell your friend you really catch the brakes, isn't it?
Hello, my name is Albert Dudy.
I'm here for tattoo. I'm a tattoo artist, and I come from Moria, French Polynesia. It's a mix of a lot of tattoo from Pacific, Tahiti, New Zealand, Hawaii, and Samoa. It's a mix. It's my job. I do Japanese design too, Occidental design with color sometimes. I prefer a big pattern. It's better for a long time. This kind of design, spear for fishing. This is nice. I like it. It's mixed. This is a tiki eyes in symbol to represent the Polynesian people. Very simple. This is a. The union with my girlfriend, two person, shark tooth for the power, the sun, a bird, it's very simple. Okay, goodbye. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
I woke up this morning, yawning.
Look at all this. 10 bucks, all of this. 10 bucks.
I've won this for free. For free. And this for free.
Hey, cheers, mate.
What I got?
What is that?
Watermelon.
I get it.
You get it? Oh, well. Anyway, here's what you can get next week on free.
I said to Sunny Pio, I said, Sunny Pio, look at me.
It's special to me. It's my partner that's tattooing me, so yeah.
He said because of my face, so here I am.
And I'm punching all the best boy.
But all the women in my family have faith for you.
The love for love, I'm also new cuisine. And that was fresh.
Thanks for hanging out with us. It's been cool. I'm going to get more pork buns. What are you doing?
Yeah, I've done it.